We now have the incredible pleasure and the honor of inviting to the stage the woman who has her newest book and most amazing story, Life on the Road, the incomparable, incredible feminist leader, wonderful human being, friend for life, Ms. Gloria Steinem'S!
There's no way I can follow that. I mean, cut it out. Okay, I know that I and most of us here are here for reliable Betty magic, right? But I also know there are some people who are hearing Betty magic for the very first time. How many people are here for the first time? Okay, so I want to tell you that they always invite their friends who play music, who sing, who, you know, to perform. And I am their only friend who does none of those things. So over the years, I have been required to write something. I have written the 10 top reasons why Jesus was a nicer guy than you think. But you can read the Gnostic Gospels and find that out for yourself. It turns out he never said he was the Son of God a whole lot, right? Okay. The cross is an African symbol. You feel better about him already? Right, okay. And the 10 top places to occupy. Occupy, I did that. The 10 top reasons Wonder Woman should rule the world. We all know what So even though David Letterman is no longer with us, I'm still doing the 10 top reasons. So now here are the 10 top things I want for Christmas. But it's really an invitation to make your own list. So here are my one-size-fits-all, no-return gifts. 10, an abject apology from Donald Trump. For being a birther, anti-immigrant, a builder of buildings that look like big Dunhill cigarette lighters, the world's most punishing source of green cards for women who marry him, rating women as no longer tens when he himself has never been a one, going bankrupt multiple times in order to stick other people with his bad judgment debt, pretending he ever hit a home run when actually he was born on third base. Oh yes, and setting the hair weave industry back to Rogaine. If Trump doesn't apologize, I don't know how to say this, but I would like us all to remember that Hitler was actually democratically elected on a low voter turnout. Just think about that and, you know, be sure and turn out good. I would like state legislatures to stop building prisons with money that once went to universities, thus keeping too many in prison and too many in lifetime debt. And I have to say this would happen if we Americans gave ourselves the gift of knowing who the hell was in our state legislators, legislatures, but okay, what their names are and so on. 7. I'm glad we've begun to raise our daughters more like our sons. Good thing. But it will never work until we raise our sons more like our daughters. 6. I so want people to know that the gift of Black Lives Matter was first created by 3 young black women. I don't think enough people know this. Alicia Garza, Opal Tometi, and Patrice Cullors. And I want you to know there are 3 organizing guidelines. 1, lead with love. 2, low ego, high impact. and three, move at the speed of trust. Don't you feel better about the future already? Five, I want Uber to stop charging for the weather. Nobody, but nobody, charges for the weather except them. And to stop not only refusing the handicapped, but with their now 30,000 unregulated cars in New York City, driving handicapped accessible taxis out of business. Don't let Uber become Uber Alice. Four, I would like a nice Christmas thank you to President Obama. For surviving an ultra-right wing who, if they had cancer and Obama had the cure, would not accept it. Three, I want any young men who buy a gun to be treated like any young women who seek an abortion. I have to say that I did not invent this. It's on the web, but I want to say thank you to whoever who did. Okay. Mandatory 48 hours waiting period for both, written permission from a parent or a judge, a note from his doctor proving that he understands what he is about to do by buying a gun, time spent watching a video on individual and mass murders, traveling hundreds of miles at his own expense to the nearest gun shop, then walking through protesters holding photos of loved ones killed by guns and calling him a murderer. After all, it makes a lot more sense to do this for young men seeking guns than for young women seeking an abortion. No young woman seeking reproductive freedom has murdered a room full of strangers. I rest my case. I want the three magical women of Betty to have everything they need to spread the Betty effect around the world. They are such a gift to us and to them. They organize with music, and it's irresistible. And finally, I personally want to make it to 100. Because I don't want to leave. I love it here. And you in this room are the greatest gift of all.